Roger Marshall, and he's four lanes.
Right, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
was that he should live in Warwickshire, registered him in with New Holland in 36, remained with the owner until 72, when sold for restoration. First restoration completed in 84, then it moved to Coventry, and this gentleman's owned the car for 12 months.
Why he hasn't got a number.
Right, this is a 1935 model Y. And they mentioned it down again with a number.
Where are you from?
Okay, 1935 model Y.
Carlisle.
The gentleman comes from Carlisle. Goes all the way down to Carlisle to be with us today in the rain. That shows a bit of dedication. Purchased it in 1991. Chris Holder, the tax trader from 1950. URS Henri Over in 1976, sold at Alberton and converted to a horse box in 1983. The birth brothers had it for 4 years. The vehicle is used weekly for horse shows and also for carrying hay. As I said, that's a 1960 four-cylinder petrol trainer. Mr. Powell owns this from Kent, and as he said, he gets about a left to the governor of all four-star.
Paperwork on it, but I would say it's a BB.
shows here that they've driven from Yorkshire, not brought on a loader or a trailer, but driven. And I would like to think that gentleman got a trophy just for that, if nothing else. It's a lovely class from 1929, owned by Dave Penn, who obviously sells lubricants and greases. A beautiful example. 3300, same engine, obviously, as the one main car. It's a Manchester built one, not American one, and it's been rebuilt over 2 years from the chassis up, and it's a credit to the gentleman. Thank you very much indeed. And if you get a chance later on, have a look at the interior of that van, because it's absolutely gorgeous. It's all sort of varnished wood interior, and it really is nice. As I say, to actually drive something like that this far, I mean, that gentleman deserves a medal of some sort.
357.
Paul O'Young owns this, and he's from Thatcher in Berkshire. Getting there now, there used to be a lot of Oregon-y cars. Never that many pickups, but there's a lot of Oregon-y cars. That's Oregon-y Mansell. Getting there now, nice to see one in that sort of thing. He put it in pieces in 1990, restoration took 23 months, and he has attended the Orford Rally since then. And now he won't carry two ton of pallets. There you go, thank you very much.
I'm
tragedy. You know, it's all on the front cover with all the associated write-up on it. Right, Ford 100E, it says, which of course is a 300E in the case of a 100E van. 1960. Ray Reynolds is one of these from they said is buzz, as you would expect from the writing on the side. Purchased in 1992, restored, and it is now used daily, which is the way I would like to see it. Thank you very much, sir. I actually know where there's one of those in a very sorry state, and I'm very tempted to buy it. Get my man Bob to weld it up and do it around in Andy Sarkar movie star. Send the engine to door, but that can't be, because that's the one behind. That is the boiler fan. So we got nothing on this.
Diesel.
problem. I wish I could make it out of it. But you know, it wasn't starting your feed in it. But you have to live on the hill beginning to start. This is a different one. I mean, I've been visiting with a few young people with 3D engines, but in the fire engine at all. And it's got the original championship box to enjoy. Back to the parking. Back to the future. You better start saying you did that, we'll put one in the Mississippi console.
What about you from?
Ivor.
Oh, Ivor. I should have had a word.
suppose that Pete knows that gentleman well, if the truth was known. He probably sold it him, yes.
Right, Gumby K. There's a name to be heard of him. Sunday in Bedfordshire. Ford Bradley Evan, 1956. Not the 1172 sign now. Still, transported on holiday on the Isle of Wight. Not at the Isle. A week later, 4 years through the storm, as the gentleman's name is John Perryman, Perryman. And it's from sunny Bedfordshire, and that lovely top of blue on that, nice colour that is, heading to you. Thank you very much, sir. Nice to think that somebody would go to trouble and bring that home to the Isle of Wight, restoring what is a rare motor vehicle these days. Too much of our heritage has either been lost or shipped to America or something. It is a shame. Ford, 1947, you could call very much down in where they were, and those were really men. Give it to yourself, this one. And the East Coast Buckleberry.
Yeah, actually, that's just a thing. I suppose this is your original sort of
people carrier, your original space cruiser, or what they call it these days. So, yeah, Ford Galaxy.
Yeah, the original of Ford Galaxy. This is a 7-seater minibus with 4,000 feet, carrying from a van. The gentleman has owned the van since 1984, and he is the second owner from you. And when he purchased it, it was in poor condition. Clifford Pierce from Buckleberry, near Reading. Thank you.
What could we have, classes?
Could we have class 4 starting to come into the arena, please?
Could we have class 4 starting to come into the arena, please? Good mate, it's all the time, though. We're on time as well. This pony from Ivory, must be another one of Tekamon Fenwick's friends, I suppose. Shorter 1937, to this timber, model 79. An American truck assembled at that in the right-hand drive worked always 33 years in Datchet, in Buckinghamshire, after it was sold, after which it was sold to its first owner for restoration. There you go, Mr. Pony from Piper Heath. And I think there's another one of his vehicles coming up behind.
Well, this is the Ford A. 24 horsepower, 4-cylinder drop side.
What would that move mean? Would that be a one-ton truck, sir? That is a one-ton. Yes, Ford Model A, one-ton truck. Purchased it in 1967, complete rebuild in 1993, and all its working life was spent in Exeter on general orders by the original owner of Mr. J.C.
Right, here's the shepherd's,
Bombay A.
Yes, off my truck in
1929, a regular at the shows. Comes to the old steam rally that I go to, all round much marker and up and on 7 and up, so we'll see it at the steam rally. Lovely truck, like I said, a regular at the shows guys. This one spent most of his life in the southern counties of England. Then the West End for 4 or 5 years in the late 80s, returned to the Sussex for 2 to 3 years, and was purchased by the first owner in 1993, refurbished in 1994. That's Ford Shepherd from Brooklyn.
Oh, why don't you say you've got him off in lorry as well, sir?
Yeah. And usually comes a pair to the steam lorry, so that'll be off in the Ford lorry. All done up in the same delivery, and there is no same book. Thank you, indeed.
I've got the little Dexter, well, Super Dexter, who's been a bit naughty there.
Right, I'm going to give the old talk.
It was a sign of shame. It was a sign of shame.
They did make a in the franchise, but it was a small club. As I say, Roy is from Kingston, it's just up the road from me. In good position, $2 to them, all his brothers. Roy, thank you very much for me.
I'm used to this one. Right.
It looks like it's going to be a dark angry. Well, this vehicle though just as part was formed just as may. And obviously the man is turning into a complete road going vehicle. Where did he come from?
Gambling
guy. Gambling, are you from Gambling Guy as well? There's all the two people in Gambling Guy.
Only just.
Thank you very much indeed. Could we have, from this is an emergency, could we have the first aid to drop to ambulance or a doctor, please, over to the PA caravan. Behind there you will see the nostalgia cars over there. Could we please have the first aid? This again, we've got 1172 four cylinder engine. This bang button around this one. From Hell's in the Isle of Wight. Brilliant. And we always get a posse of people from the Isle of Wight coming to the All Four Rally every year. So wonderful to see people coming all down the way, across the ferry. You didn't get grounded in London then, so. So they normally need to lay this over, have to go relatively earlier in the afternoon to catch the ferry to get back. So it's brilliant to see it come over. The car was sold, not new. Thank you. called Hudson Frost. And is this one, is that right?
Right.
He comes out from Cleveland. First in 1988 to 63. He has been sat in a wheelchair for 15 years. It took him 6 years to restore his vision, or to say, and all his brother. Although we are not keen to be exposed to a great pain, I must admit, he's always been a lucky fellow for me, for not to other people. But that's really made a nice step of that. Thank you very much, indeed.
Of the road face charges Mark 1 Thompson. That one I'll be telling you about this hour is identical to that.
That's
the
backwards.
What's
the history of the road?
1508
DC, this one. Mr. Nash, this is from Brian Lee, based 13.5 years. It may have a pussy point of 10 from the road to the original. Brilliant. I don't know where it is, but that's really a piece of money at all. Trying to persuade them to let me out of it, you know what I mean? But it's a, he's talking about their base, so it's one of my favourite cars, the Apple Boots, the Ellen, both those. Really, 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 really,
Used now for Virgin and Show. Must be exactly the same jet plane
That's what he did on the Korean plant. Right, 1935 through the Zodiac, it's not the Barber and Rose, absolute soldier. Why more expensive than the Rose, the older one? This vehicle was built in December 1954, registered in January 1954. It has only had two owners of view. The present owner has an assigned car for 18 years. This year, back on the road after being laid up. Oh, it's good transport. Of course, I said that was the end of the fault. I wanted to fire off.
high line, and it's first produced at acceleration 6, in the oldest marches still on the road today.
So if anybody knows where the older one, just go close to that.
Where is it come from?
Girls, you say, girls.
Lovely. I'm going to be a winder. Brilliant. That's it.
Thanks for having me.
V8 pilot. Gorgeous vehicle.
Really, sir? Would you like to tell me about the vehicle?
Thanks very much indeed.
49 pilot.
Yeah.
Oh. Right.